Welcome to the future.
Your future's looking pretty grim, Desan.
On the contrary, thanks to you, the weakling Jedi who scorned me will soon be erased from history, replaced by a new race of warriors. Strong warriors, warriors who know that the Force is not a shield to protect the useless, but is in reality a weapon to empower the worthy.
None of that's gonna happen, Desan. Most of your shadow troopers are being mopped up by real Jedi, ones who've been trained to use the Force. The rest blew up with your ship.
What a pathetic ruse. Desan to Fayar. Admiral? Admiral! Admiral Fayar, I order you to come in at once! I was wrong about you, Katarn. Your failure as a Jedi hasn't weakened you. It's only made you stronger. Come, join me. You know in your heart that you'll never truly be one of them.
Maybe, maybe not. But I know I won't be alone. How about you, Desan? Even now, after all this pain, it's not too late. Come, join us.
Sweet fool!
Ah, Kyle, you naive little fool. Of course he's not gonna join you.
Will betray you to me.
Actually, I'm gonna admit that I looked up what the damn thing in the middle does again, cause I didn't look it up, as in, on the internet, tried it out, and honestly, it doesn't do a whole lot. No, I'm sure it's terribly useful, but, and this is how you activate it, but you barely, you know, you have to stand still in the middle of it. Which is kind of impossible with him on your ass. As, by the way. As, you know, he keeps, pushing and pulling you off, and god damn it, whatever happened to blocking? See what I mean about being pushed and pulled around? And for some reason, he's so physically strong that he can do that. Actually, that trick simply exists, but... wow. But, yeah, I don't know. Maybe that would make me stronger. Wait, wouldn't it kill me now? Whoa, stop that. Stop that! Force push, hello! Thanks for that, Desan. Nope, now I'm gonna go here. Wrong side. Also wrong side. No, we only run to heal back up. I think now that beam would kill us though. Doesn't it? No, it doesn't. I don't know, I still don't know what it does. Would you force push him? See? You get on there. Stop that.
Does a Jedi run from battle?
Ah, damn it.
Save your strength, fool.
Of course, if in doubt, force speed and just wail on him. Ooh, but run away when it runs out. Yeah, sure. No! Stop doing that at once. Oh boy. Some more force, please. Ah, come on! Leave me. alone. Lovely, they create a boss fight where you, you know, where the boss immobilizes you. Like no other Jedi in the whole game can do. I'm sure there's a trick to beating him involving that damn thing in the middle. But, yeah, I think the thing is broken. Yeah, gee. Actually, it gives me temporary immunity. Immunity over. So, I won, I think. It's my quasi immunity, 4 speed. Could have activated God mode from the get-go then. If that's all the light beam does. Were you supposed to say something? Like, alas pour de son, I barely knew him. Yeah, off-screen that kiss, you naughty, naughty boys and girls. The widescreen alteration. Great for YouTube, bad for the cutscenes.
Kyle, Jan, someday you're gonna have to teach me how to do that.
Thanks for taking care of the Raven's Claw.
It was the least I could do for the pair of mercenaries who saved the Jedi Academy. I know you've probably heard this before, but the New Republic is forever in your debt.
You should have known it would take a failed Jedi to take out another failed Jedi.
Kyle, you were never a failure.
Luke,
I know. I'll be happy to hold your lightsaber for safekeeping.
No, I think I'll keep it.
Ha! I knew it! Lando owes me 5 credits.
Are you sure this is what you want, Kyle?
Look, I'm not saying I'm ready to join the Academy or anything like that. I mean, before I do anything, I figure that Jan and I have earned a long vacation on the beaches of Spira. And after that, well...
After that, we'll see.
Yeah.
Take your time, Kyle. We'll still be here when you're ready.
Thanks, and may the Force be with you, Luke.
On the beaches of Spira? Isn't Spira where Final Fantasy X takes place? So you're standing on a balcony and laughing at each other in a really bad and stilted way? Huh. That's not how I imagine Kyle Katarn. But the way I do imagine him is as the hero of one of the most awesome games ever. Even though I whined a lot, especially towards the end, and the boss is kind of bleh. It's kind of lame, because, you know, you beat him by becoming invincible with a light thing in the middle. I should have figured that out, but... And I sort of guessed that that's what it was, but I could never really test it because it was over by the time I got up after Disan, you know, kept pushing me all over the Jedi Temple. So yeah, I considered it useless because you know, beating him with 4 speed was is kind of much easier, I think, because that's what I did in the end, and yeah. Editing nightmare, but then again, why do I have a timer anyway? Actually, not that much of an editing nightmare. But anyway, yeah, so that was Jedi Outcast, sequel to one of the most awesome games ever, Jedi Knight, which I can't LP, because it crashes on me all the time, but I think I said that at the very beginning of the LP. So yeah, Billy Dee Williams as Lando Calrissian, yay! Who did Luke? I think I missed... No, Bob Bergen, I've never heard of him. Anyone else? Kevin, no. Tom Kane as a reborn Rodian and a Shadow Trooper. You know who Tom Kane is? Yoda in the Clone Wars cartoon. And in Republic Commando, and I pointed that out there too. But yeah, Jedi Knight was awesome, and it was awesome because it has awesome level design. Same thing goes for Jedi Outcast, actually. It may not be the prettiest game anymore, because, you know, the Quake 3 engine is getting old. But, while Jedi Knight is really ugly now, because of early 3D, and the Quake 3 engine kind of still works, even though you see all the mistakes it does more than the things it does right. But yeah, the lightsaber looks okay, and that's what matters after all. And that's the thing, really, because this game does get the whole Star Wars aesthetic kind of right. The Stormies look perfectly fine, because, you know, they're kind of blocky and edgy, you know, in the sense that they have edges all over them, not, you know, cool and edgy. Yeah, and that's why they work in an old, on an old graphics engine too. So yeah, the Reborn shouldn't work, because, you know, infusing the Force into people, kind of iffy concept, but, well, in a sense, it does work, because it works with objects too, but let's not go there. Jedi Academy I'll do after the next LP, which should be Half-Life 2. Yeah. And after Academy I'll do the episodes, probably both one after the other, instead of, you know, episode 1 and then another game. Unless Trine 2 comes out until then, or in the meantime. Then I'll have exclusive rights. So yeah, German dubbing studio. Yeah, they would list that. The Spanish one they're on there too, I didn't pay attention. Because you do have the game in English, German and Spanish. I think Academy I actually played in Spanish once. I do not speak a word of Spanish. And I don't particularly like or dislike the language all that much. It's not like, you know, Italian or French where I... you know, French I had in school and forgot everything because I think it sucks to learn. And it sucks to speak. It's not that good. Hey, yeah! Music, of course, composed by John Williams. People complain that, Star Wars games overuse the John Williams music from the movies. I don't see what's wrong with it, really, because for the longest time, I only knew the tracks by the games before I got the soundtracks and the movies. Yeah, the awesome-looking Jedi Knight logo craps out in because of the widescreen thing. And yeah, just on quick note to finish the thought on the music. I don't mind when the Star Wars games use music from the movies. But at the same time, I don't mind if they have original compositions. KOTOR sounds totally fine, except that I don't listen to any of it on its own. Much unlike with the actual Star Wars scores. Yeah, but then again, I do listen to film scores all the time, and I would use them in montages all the time if that wouldn't very likely get me in copyright trouble on YouTube. So I keep using video game music, or in the case of the fast forwards on this game, weird remixes of the Star Wars music that floated around the internet in the 90s. And I still have them on various hard drives. So yeah, that was Jedi Outcast. I had my fun because I really liked this game. Again, I moan a lot, but I think you're used to that by now, aren't you? That I do that even on games that I like. I whined on Half-Life. Because, you know, when a game throws bullshit at me, I go, oh, come on, that's bullshit. And now I broke my swearing quota for the month. So, yeah, I shall shut up. Leave this fuggy as actually, it's not that ugly. I used the Jedi Knight logo as my icon on various forums for ages. Even on Steam. Actually, I still use it on Steam. But, yeah, wait. Where is the sound? No. Options? Yeah. Voice. Oh, no Spanish? I could have sworn I played Academy in Spanish and not in French. But you know what? You get a taste of Outcast in German now. Give me some old level. In editing just now, I noticed that I never actually said thanks for watching and goodbye. So, yeah, I'll append it in a post recording. So yeah, thanks for watching and goodbye. Man, I'm so silly sometimes.
Willkommen bei der Akademie der Jedi, Sir. Master Skywalker erwartet Sie oben bereits.
Danke. Ich denke, ich finde den Weg selbst.